2-8 of the Belgian Air Component with the F-16AM. Fighting Falcon, the Dark Falcon, on the rollout. The two D-Day F-16s come in above before the press collapse.
to keep up with the ribbon diagram to work out what's coming next.
That's it.
Typhoons from RAF Lossiemouth, led by Wing Commander Jim Lee of No. 2 Army Cooperation Squadron. They come from Escadrille 727 of the Royal Danish Air Force at Skridstrup, 331 Squadron of the Royal Norwegian Air Force at Buda, 2 Wing of the Belgian Air Component at Floren, and 313 Squadron of the Royal Netherlands Air Force at Volkel. After them, the German Luftwaffe's contribution, a single Eurofighter EF-2000 from Taktisches Luftwaffengeschwader 71 Richthofen at Wittmundhafen. And then a very rare sight in a British flying display, the French Air Force Boeing KC-135R Stratotanker tanker from Group de Ravitaillement Vol 291 Bretagne at Nice in the hands of Capitaine Benoit Jaeger. Fighter wing at RAF Lakenheath in Suffolk, led by Captain Mark Venturino.
Knots and the two-set section will be airborne. such indication by the leader of total energy in terms of speed and height at the top of this mother.
Sound threats eliminated, the crew can climb into a wheel, circling the target to assess and ensure the flight effects are in the vicinity. Because the scavenger cameras is interrupted, as the pilots want any soldiers from the dug-in position, bringing a heavy machine gun to bear in the aircraft direction. Out to beyond 4 kilometres with a cyclic rate of 625 rounds a minute. Above the main range of this, you mention the distinctive shape of the aircraft fire control radar. The radar is able to scan out to 8 kilometres, testing over 1,000 targets, prioritising it, offering the pilot 16 simultaneous fire stations through the aircraft's reference process.
We did great airplanes together, and for sure we know that we are both part of NATO, and as motto for the NATO, we are stronger together. And so in from the right-hand side, again the Red Arrows, leading the Patrouille de France, the smoke about to come on for the second Concorde pass. Upside down at 2,500 feet, the white smoke on as we roll Apollo. At the back of the formation on the right is Red 4, another new pilot for 2019. Red 4 is Flight Lieutenant Gregor Oxen for the Lancaster roll. Not noted for its aerobatic capabilities, but it's reputed that the famous test pilot Alex Henshaw rolled the Lancaster numerous times when testing at the Castle Bromwich during the war. The flight straight down the middle in the goose.
Number one, now.
Red 9 is Flight Lieutenant Dan Lowe's. Dan formerly flew the Typhoon and was a weapons instructor. He's in his third and final year on the team. Ladies and gentlemen, you've been watching the Red Arrows! Possibly as steep as 120 degrees, another one of these manoeuvres with tactical relevance, showing how the aircraft could rapidly evade small arms fire or the risk of attention from man pads and the like. Turning to low level, axis, they can also fly off highway strips